Thank you for agreeing to meet with me. Perhaps you have already guessed what I wish to discuss. The word Capitale does not mean anything to you? Huh. For some time now, the organization that I represent has been using a unique system of exchange for our more sensitive business dealings. This we call Capitale. Private bonds with their value guaranteed by the reputation and considerable resources of my employer. It's a more civilized way of doing things. It cannot be allowed to continue. The value of Capitale depends on a certain exclusivity. Understand? I don't know how much you have heard of our ambitious new senator, Anton Ricard. He's an officious, naive man who has yet to learn how politics work. About his grand plans to make Lemoyne the star of the next year's state fair in Sacramento. He has also been making life very difficult for us.
Come on.
Excuse me for a moment.
Well, forgive me, Signor. I thought we'd be meeting alone.
Who is this?
He was just arrested by one of my men in the old quarter. I thought you might be interested to see what they found in his possession.
How did you come by this?
I swear to you, I
did. On your knees.
I did. I found it. I did.
On your knees.
I swear to you. No, no, please.
Where did you steal it?
I promise you that I didn't steal it.
I will ask you only one more time. Where did you steal it?
From some of the Cornwalls, boys. Leviticus Cornwall.
Thank you, Chief. I trust this man will face the full penalty of the law.
Most assuredly, Signor.
Good. Proceed.
Was there, anything else?
No, I think that was enough, don't you?
Yes, sir.
In return, I will reward you with a unique business opportunity involving our friend, Senator Ricard. But that is for later. I wish to see the quality of your work before I reveal my hand. I'm sure you understand. Now, it is best we do not meet again. All further communication will be through my intermediaries. Some of them are friends of yours already. I believe Mr. Foreman, Mr. Langton. In any case, bring them enough capitale to impress me, and I assure you it will be worth your while. Now, if you excuse me, buona caccia.
Glad you came. Thank you.
It seems your efforts have not been entirely in vain. Have produced some rather surprising results. Well, not surprising, but...
Confusing. After castigating me as a widow, a harlot, a fool, a mad woman, anything and everything. Suddenly, shortly after we killed his brother-in-law, Amos Lansing wants to talk. He sent word via an intermediary.
Mr. Jones.
Crazy old fool said not to trust any of it.
Which is why we need you. You're to help keep Mrs. LeClerc protected during the meeting at Blackwood.
I shouldn't imagine they would kill us in broad daylight, but you never know. I never imagined they'd kill my husband, nor turn me into a fugitive. Anyway, friends, today may go end of ways, but I want to make sure once the shooting starts, all of them end up dead.
One of you drive the wagon. The other, keep guard.
Thank you. All of you. This means... Well, it means something. I don't know exactly what yet, but...
I
don't think any of us think Mr. Lansing has become a saint, madam, but perhaps we should hear him out.
Perhaps.
And who killed my husband?
Your husband? That little milksop? I guess I imagine he was your brother. No woman would ever marry his kind. I did kill him. I did it. And he was begging for his life. Pathetic, really.
Who put you up to it? Who?
Lady, that's none of your damn business.
Then I guess we'll kill the lot of them. That's one down, three to go. Mr. Horley, pay our friends for their service.
Thank you. We shall be in touch.